was a new thing. And I mean, I knew some of the legends were starting. Some of the guys, one guy, Martin Aparillo, was part of the Vans Breakers. He was a locker and a breaker. And that was a major change, was the Vans Breakers. And they had practice right around the corner for me in the park. Not very far. So, we used to practice there, and there was like Lester Psy, who was a professional skateboarder.
Uh-huh.
That's the first person I ever saw do windmills with my own, like, in front of me. Not on a video, not in a movie.
Yeah.
Lester Psy, he was touring, he was sponsored, I don't remember the company, but he was touring, and so I think he just come back from the East Coast and was like, check this out. He jumped on the windmill, like, you got that, I'm doing the windmills, what are you doing? And I was just like, whoa. So I had some of those people to look up to, but that carried just that whole scene and that whole lifestyle of hearing what we do was always part of me when I was, trying to find myself in hip hop, this new thing. And like I said, so around 86, 87, I couldn't find anybody to practice with me. And I was really emotional about it. Like, people were just giving up on it. And the thing with me is I'm an extremely loyal person, and so I was loyal to this new art form that kind of took me from being a real nerdy kid, not fitting in, to being somewhat respected. And I wasn't really dope then. I didn't have I had my name, but I didn't have any following. But I just fell into it again.